Hello everyone, how are you? Today I'll show you how to animate wall openings and windows in a variety of styles. I'll be using these animated walls and floors from previous tutorials, and I've created a playlist with all my animated room tutorials so you can create your own from scratch. Okay, let's begin. Let's start with the different opening variations. I'm gonna take the cursor to the world origin, add a cube, scale it down. Let's place it and make sure it sticks out from both sides of the wall. It doesn't need to be so thick, so let's scale it down a bit. I want the cube to be centered, and I'm gonna change the color type to random so you can see the objects better. This wall has some modifiers already, since I created it in my previous video. Link in the description in case you are curious. Add a boolean modifier, set the cube as the boolean object and hide it in viewports and in renders. To fix the wall hole looking weird, change the shading to Shade Auto Smooth. You can also add a bevel modifier to the boolean object to play around with the shape of the cube, and you'll get a rounder wall opening. To get rid of these lines, you can add a subdivision modifier. Now the opening looks smoother. I'm gonna leave this one like this. You can also create different types of openings by adding other primitives. Another way of smoothing the opening's lines is by choosing Shade Smooth. Let's change this shape a bit to get a different window. You can also create more elaborate shapes, like an arc window for example, by beveling the top edges. Shade Smooth so the lines get smoother, and to make them even smoother, add a subdivision modifier. Okay, now let's animate the wall opening in different styles. Let's take a look at our animation. Now the opening remains still, but what if you wanted it to appear gradually? We simply need to insert a scale keyframe, go to another frame, scale to 0, and set a keyframe. Let's see. Let's make it a bit slower, and I want the animation to start sooner. And here it is. We could create another type of animation. Add two shape keys, in edit mode, move the back face until it doesn't touch the wall anymore, choose the final frame, insert a value keyframe, choose another frame, set the value to 1 and insert a keyframe. You can create the same effect by changing the origin to the front face and animating the scale transform on the x-axis. Now let's model different types of windows. First, let's start with the frame. Duplicate this cube, escape, hide one of the cubes, remember to show the duplicate in renders, delete the keyframes, and if you used shape keys to animate it, delete them as well. In edit mode, enable X-ray mode to make sure we select both the front and the back face. Insert face and delete. Select all and scale down on the X-axis to make it thinner. I'm gonna move it. Now select these outer edges and fill. And repeat. Select these three, fill, do it again. And now select this edge loop and fill. Let's scale it down a bit more and move. Now let's model the window. Select this loop of faces, duplicate, escape, and separate by selection. Back to object mode, select this new object, and in edit mode, select all and fill. Add a loop cut right in the middle and delete half of the object. Select this edge loop and fill. scale on the x-axis a bit. Select the front and the back face. Insert face. Extrude, escape, and scale on the x-axis. If both faces don't scale towards the middle, make sure the pivot point is set to medium point. Add a loop cut and add two loop cuts. Select these new faces we have now. Insert face and enable individual. Extrude, escape, and scale on the x-axis. Let's hide everything so we can select this edge and set the 3D cursor to that selection. And back to object mode, origin to 3D cursor. Later we're gonna move the window from here, so that's why we changed the origin there. I want another window, so let's add a mirror modifier. I want the frame to be a bit thinner since I didn't like how the thick frame looked when animated. Select the back faces and move. And let's do the same with the window. And scale it on the x-axis a bit. And move it forward. Move the array modifier on top, apply it, and in edit mode, select all and separate by loose parts. I'm gonna duplicate the window and the frame just because I'll create more animations later. We need to set the origin to the side to match the other window. Select the side edges, cursor to selected, and origin to 3D cursor. Let's set the frame's origin to the bottom, since I want the pivot point to be there for the animation. To model a double hang window, let's scale the frame, duplicate it, scale it down, in edit mode, select all, cursor to selected, and while still in edit mode, add a plane to use as the window glass. Rotate it, scale it down, and in object mode, duplicate it. Move it on the x-axis a bit, and we need to scale the boolean object so the wall opening matches this window. And here we have it. If you'd like to model this type of window instead, you can watch this tutorial. Let's animate the different windows we've modeled. Let's add a few more frames. Let's go to the end of the timeline. We're gonna need the transform panel. And since we're gonna animate the rotation on the z-axis, let's escape. Set a rotation keyframe for that axis only on both windows. Choose another frame and rotate the window on the z-axis. Let's choose 35. Set a keyframe and for the other window, set a value of minus 35. And set a keyframe. To make both the frame and window rotate and scale from the bottom without changing their origins, add an empty here at the bottom, scale it a bit and select these three. Then select the empty and parent object. Let's see. We'll rotate the empty on the y-axis. First, I'm gonna move these keyframes so the animation is a bit slower. Now choose a frame and set a rotation keyframe on the y-axis. Go to another frame, rotate on the y-axis and insert a keyframe. And here it is. Now set a scale keyframe on the z-axis, choose another frame, set the z-axis to 0, and insert a keyframe for the 3-axis. Choose another frame, scale to 0, and insert a scale keyframe. I want the animation to start in frame 83, so we need to move the keyframes of the windows, the frame, and the empty. Let's see. For my second window animation, I'm gonna use the duplicates I made earlier, and let's join them. Origin to geometry, choose the final frame, and we're gonna animate the x-axis. Insert a keyframe, and now we're gonna animate the rotation on the y-axis. Set a keyframe, go to another frame, move on the x-axis, and insert a keyframe. And now rotate on the y-axis 360 degrees, and set a keyframe. In the last keyframe, set a scale keyframe, and in the first keyframe, scale to 0 and insert a keyframe. Let's take a look. And you could always move some keyframes to create a different animation, for example by moving the final scale keyframes. I like the other way better, so I'm gonna undo this. And let's move all the keyframes so the animation starts a bit sooner. To create these two animations, I used the same techniques that I employed in this tutorial. I animated the joint mesh the same way I animated these windows. It's a very simple animation, I only used a couple of location and scale keyframes. And in that same tutorial, I teach how to model and animate windows this way. To animate the double hand window, first I animated the frame separately the same way I animated this window, and next I animated the top sash going down, then the bottom one, and I used booleans to hide them, otherwise it will look like this. I talk about this technique in that same video, and I also cover some other animation tips, so I recommend you check it out. Also, I recommend you learn about easing your animations to take them to the next level. You can ease the animations by selecting the keyframes and choosing the easing or the interpolation mode, or to get more control you can play around with the curves in the graph editor. I have two videos where I cover this subject. Let's take this window animation as an example. I'm just gonna ease the location keyframes, so I need to lock the scale keyframes. Let's select this keyframe, and I'm gonna move this handle. Let's see. Let's undo this. Now I'm gonna move this handle instead to create a different easing effect. Let's ease the final keyframe too. And we could move this handle as well. Let's have a look. This is just a real quick overview of what you can do in the graph editor. And this could be the difference between a robotic animation and a more interesting stylized one. And as you can see, our animated room is coming alive by using all the techniques I've been showing you in my last videos. I even created a playlist so you can create your own animated rooms as well. All the links to these videos are in the description. I hope you're enjoying this type of tutorials. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye!